There are definitely some stories that are better left alone, that when you start to reimagine and rewrite are complete and utter disasters. And this headline isn't one I think I'd ever see, because they are doing a new 1984 book, but it's going to be a feminist retelling. They're doing a rewrite of a story that warns about the danger of rewriting history. I have a couple of different things that I want to show off, but before we get into the topic at hand, if you enjoy the content that I create, please make sure to subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell. Follow me on social media like Twitter or mine so that you can see when all of my new content is posted. And if you do really enjoy the videos and the live streams that I create, please consider becoming a Dark Titan via Patreon for just $1 a month, or becoming a supporter via YouTube memberships. All of the links are in the description, and of course, I do really appreciate all of the support. So I wanted to start off with this Bounding Into Comics article. It says George Orwell's 1984 gets a feminist retelling with approval from the late author's estate. And yet another example of the book's dystopian story being taken as a guidebook rather than a cautionary warning. George Orwell's 1984 is set to receive a feminist retelling, which will see the story retold from the point of view of Julia, the love interest of the original novel's protagonist, Winston Smith. Now, I'm sure most of you have read George Orwell's 1984, but if you haven't, it's a dystopian novel that tells the story of Winston Smith, and it warns about the dangers of a totalitarian government that rules through brainwashing, fear, surveillance, propaganda, all of these things. But it says, penned by author Sandra Newman, the aptly titled Julia will explore the events of 1984 through the character's female perspective, who, as noted by the book's publisher, understands the world of Oceania far better than Winston and is essentially happy with her life, which is absolutely ridiculous to hear. She has known no other world and, until she meets Winston, never imagined one. She's opportunistic, believes in nothing, and caring not at all about the politics. She routinely breaks the rules but also collaborates with the regime whenever necessary. She's an ideal citizen, it says, and then of course it goes on to explain her role in the book. She hands him a note, a potentially suicidal gesture. She comes to realize that she's losing her grip and can no longer safely navigate her world. I truly cannot believe that they greenlit this. A feminist rewrite of 1984 is one of the most 1984 things I've heard. They're seriously trying to break down cautionary tales like this now. Of course, it'll be no surprise when this bombs, and we know it 100% will. Feminist rewrites of stories like this will never do well. I'm so sick of people reimagining stories because people behind these movies, books, TV shows, entertainment can't write, so they have to take other people's creations and change them around. It's honestly like they want this to fail from the start, and they want people to hate it. I think if they just marketed it as 1984 from Julia's point of view, most people wouldn't care that much. You know, but when they're marketing it as a feminist retelling of an important tale, it instantly diminishes that interest. But this is probably the worst of all. According to the literary executor of Orwell's estate, Bill Hamilton, the estate had been looking for some time for someone to give 1984 a feminist revamp, eventually finding that Newman proved to be the perfect fit. I think that this is absolutely ridiculous. It's not only the fact that someone wanted to write 1984 as a feminist revamp. No, no. It's that they were looking specifically for someone to do that. I truly and genuinely do not understand why they thought that this was a good idea, why they thought this was gonna go over well with people, but of course it's not. This project is already facing major backlash, and rightfully so. I think this next quote is really important. In 1984, it says, "Every record has been destroyed or falsified. Every book has been rewritten. Every picture has been repainted. Every statue and street building has been renamed. Every date has been altered. And that process is continuing day by day and minute by minute. History has stopped." They think that rewriting something like 1984 is going to go over well, and it's not. If we go on over to Twitter, this author decided to put out a tweet with the Guardian article on it saying feminist retelling of 84 approved by Orwell's estate, and she had said, "Okay, so this is my big news for today. I am writing a feminist retelling of Orwell's 1984, and it's gotten a lot of traction because a lot of people are talking about it. There are definitely people in this comment section defending her, saying, you know what, this is a great idea. I can't wait to see it. I'm going to 100% support. This is fantastic." But there are also a lot of people saying this is the worst idea imaginable. People are saying things like, "Isn't this a bit sad? Why not write your own dystopian novel? Doesn't it imply that you don't have the imagination to come up with your own story, that you have to rework a man's story?" And I 100% agree. These people have no imagination and no creativity of their own. If they wanted to write their own dystopian novel, they should. I mean, there are plenty of dystopian stories about men and women. I mean, look at something like The Handmaid's Tale. It's the story of the life in a dystopian of Gilead, a totalitarian society where, of course, women are treated like property of the state. And The Handmaid's Tale was a book from many, many years ago, but it was also made into a TV show because the book sold so well. A lot of people watch the show. It's one of Hulu's most popular series about dystopian futures and women and rights can be done well. But taking something like 1984 and twisting it around and putting it into a different perspective doesn't really come across that well. People are saying things like, "I don't see why do you want to make an inherently inferior version unless it was done purely as a joke." And it's true, everyone is going to view this as a joke. I don't see this book selling well. I don't know if they're trying to make a movie out of it or anything. As far as the original articles say, they're just doing a book of it right now. But honestly, it wouldn't surprise me if they tried to make it into a movie or a TV show at some point, because this is what they want. They want to take important works like 1984, twist them around, switch narratives, do different point of views, and then remarket them for a new modern audience, which is absolutely disgusting, and I truly do not think something like 1984 should be reimagined. They literally decided to rewrite a book that was about the dangers of rewriting history. I do not think that this is going to come out and it's going to go over well. Maybe it'll come out and it'll be an absolutely spectacular book. Maybe we'll all be wrong. Maybe this will come out and be an absolute masterpiece, but I highly doubt it. And the irony here is just hilarious. But that's all that I really had to talk about in this video. Let everyone know your thoughts in the comment section down below. If you enjoyed it, please make sure to give it a like, share it, and subscribe to the channel. And of course, if you didn't, make sure to give it a dislike. I appreciate your support either way, but I will talk to you all again in the next video really soon.